Can I have your number? All right, and here we are in the Farmington Arena here to see another exciting girls matchup between Farmington Knightettes and the Cape Notre Dame Bulldogs. As the Farmington lineup has already been announced, we have the Cape Notre Dame lineup going on as we speak. And Jake, what are you expecting from today's matchup?
Well, I don't really know what to expect. Last season was another rough developmental season for the Knightettes. As this year, I have higher expectations, and I expect them to do better things. Hopefully, we can witness some good basketball tonight and some positive things. I'm just looking to see some solid basketball, the fundamentals. Let's get back to the fundamentals.
It's going
to
be like a San Antonio Spurs game in here. It's always about the fundamentals.
Greg Popovich, what a legend.
All right, as teams are ready to get this tip-off underway, the Knights led by new coach Rusty Sanchagoff, former Knights soccer coach, good friend of mine, and I'm excited to see what he can do to reevaluate this program.
And he's in his second season, taking over for coach Steve McFarland. As we tip off, Bradley Brackett is taking the tip for the Knightettes, and number 22 from Cape Notre Dame is taking the tip for them. I do not know her name, but we'll go with it.
Tip won by Brackett. As Haley Graven has the ball in the backcourt, gives it to Pauls as she sets up the offense. Pauls to Graven on the wing. Graven tried to get it to Brackett.
And an early turnover already. Oh, loose ball.
Notre Dame needs to call a timeout or something.
Jump ball.
Possession arrow goes to Notre Dame. So they will start off, hopefully.
Rough first possession for the Knightettes, but it is only 17 seconds into the game.
That's why we play the game. Number 10.
Steal by Bradley Brackett.
Throw it down.
And it is money. Money. And the Knightettes with an early 2-0 lead in the first quarter. Cape Notre Dame tries to set up their offense while the Knightettes are playing lockdown D right now. And
contested
that shot is no good. And it is, we got a foul. We got a block here.
See,
down low.
Foul's on number 24, Bradley Brackett, her first.
Is on the floor. Looks inside. Shot is up, and it is no good.
Rebounded by
senior Elena Davis.
Paul's running the up-tempo offense down the court. Stops, lets the offense set. Down to Brackett on the elbow. Puts a move on. Passes out to the wing to Tucker. Tucker cross court. Stolen by number 10. She's on
another
breakaway.
Turnover by the Nets on a fast break, and it is good as Cape Notre Dame ties it up 2-2.
That was just a poor pass by Tucker.
Very lazy pass. You got to put some... You gotta put some mustard on it.
Yes, you do. Brackett inside.
Brackett goes inside.
It's like a little sky hook.
Look at that.
It's good.
Is that a young Kareem? That is a white female Kareem in our presence right now.
Oh, an almost steal by Tucker, but she commits the foul. Her first.
I can see it. I'm foreshadowing that there will be a lot of fouls, and this will be a very physical game.
A lot of fouls and a lot of turnovers. Farmington already has two within the first minute and a half of this game. 10 gives it 25.
Notre Dame has one as well.
To number 15. Sorry, folks, we don't have a roster. We can just give you numbers. That foul is on the floor on number 14, Elena Davis.
Basket does not count.
Run the inbounds play to number 22, pump fakes. Out to 15, she pump fakes. Out to number 10, and
we got to travel. This isn't the NBA. They actually call it here. And it will be Knightettes ball as Haley Graven inbounds the ball as she finds Elena Davis. Back to Graven as she takes it down the court.
Okay. Tucker goes up to the half court, gives it to Pauls, and that is deflected. No backcourt. Almost stolen by number 25. She comes in again and gets the steal.
Another steal.
In fast break.
Good,
but we have two.
No, it's a foul. Holy cow. The ref obviously saw something that I didn't see on there, and so I apologize for the misconception, everybody. We're human. We all make mistakes.
We all do make mistakes. That's number right. 25 at the line.
Even Bradley Brackett.
First one is up and it is good. Rims that one out.
No good. And then offensive rebound. We got travel. Sloppy, sloppy play. Tucker to
Brackett down low. The foul. Nothing on the bucket. Looks like that'll be on the floor. Our view is a little cut off here by the scoreboard. Notre Dame looks like they're running a zone defense here on the inbound.
3-2 zone. Always one of my favorite defenses.
It's number 21 and 12. Sub in for 22 and 25. The word is we are getting a roster, so just wait a little bit, bear with us, and we'll be able to give you some names. Davis down low, puts a move on, is fouled. Number 21 claims she's straight up. The ref sees something different, and Elena Davis is going to shoot two.
The first shot is no good.
The shot is no good, and we do now have a roster.
Thank
so
you
that'll come in
to
handy.
Our fellow Grips. Shout out to the Grips.
Here's Davis up. One out of two there. This is now tied. That's Cape Notre Dame's number 12, Faith Esner.
What a name. Turnover by Cape Notre Dame.
Goes up
fast
to Paul.
Break.
Paul's
back
to Davis.
Davis. And it is no good. Use the backboard. Let's get some backboard in there. That's why we have it. Come on. Woo. Woo. Shout out to the Nature Boy.
Number 12, Esner, is back setting up the offense. Cape Notre Dame swings it around the key. Down to the elbow. Back over to number 45. 45 to 21. They go looking. Farmington defense playing very well in this series, giving them
playing
nothing.
Like Mike Anderson's Mizzou team. 40 minutes of hell.
Contested shot, no good.
Rebound by Bradley Brackett.
Pauls leads the offense up, puts a little shake and bake on number 15. Gives it into the corner to Graven. Graven down low. Brackett up to Davis. Davis puts a shot up. It is blocked.
Wow. Holy cow. That's a top 10 play
put
right there.
Put some mustard on that one.
Sports Center top 10.
Davis goes in for the steal. No good.
Elena Davis could have played for the Minnesota Lynx with that shot.
And that is another travel. Lots of turnovers early on here.
Oh, we got some subs
as
here.
As number 23, Samantha Feeney, and number 22,
Feeney,
Allie Ziegler, come in for number 25, Haley Chapman, and number 45, Lexi Welter of Notre Dame. That is a
kickball
violation.
Kickball violation.
So isn't it a soccer field?
True. Shout out to the boys' soccer team who had their best season in history this year. They lost a total of two games on the season. They were one game away from going to the state finals. And what a season. What a season. I can't be more proud.
What a time to be alive.
What a time.
Inbounds the Brackett.
And
that is tipped. And it'll stay Farmington possession. Looks like a little mouthing going on between Brackett and Ziegler.
With 4:16 left in the first, the Farmington with the lead 7-3. Very low scoring contest so far. A lot of turnovers, a lot of fouls. Very, very tough.
Lob pass into Brackett. Makes the play. And a little miscommunication there. And we're going to have a holding foul. Looks like 24. Looks like it's Brackett. And we're going to have, looks like, John Calipari platoon switch here. West, Roethlisberger, and Thurman in for Brackett, Graven, and Tucker.
Getting a breather.
So number 25, Ailey Chapman, looks to set the offense. Gives it off to number 31, Brooke Blankenship. Dishes down. Wide open player there. Defense does recover. Well, pump fake on the shot there. Shake and bake. No good. Rebound by Pauls. She runs the tempo offense.
And
gives it to Davis in the corner.
Dribble drive. Pass it to entered into the Roethlisberger, and oh, is this on the floor, or is that a three? Is this gonna be a 3-point play?
The old-fashioned three. Oh, looks like it is on the floor. We had a little confusion there.
What would the game be like if we didn't have the 3-point line? What would the game be like?
Be a lot more physical play down low. Looks like more like Tim Duncan, the big fundamental, as there's lacking fundamentals there as Davis with a travel, another turnover for Farmington.
Well, that is some man, this is rough. This is rough. But I mean, it's early. This is the first game of the year. They're rusty. It'll be okay. I mean, I believe in them. I believe that they are going to do great things this year. Improvement. Got a lot of young talent out there.
Got a lot of young talent. Got a lot of time to improve by the end of the year. I will say their defense has been well, holding them to 3 points.
And Cape Notre Dame usually shoots lights out. No.
Oh,
very
handling.
Physical play. The refs are not usual MAAA refs here, and not calling MAAA refs. If you touch them the slightest, they will call it. But tonight, they are just letting them. It's like a boxing match out there.
Tip pass by Chapman. Saved and gives it to number 31. Brooke Blankenship lays it up, and it is good off the glass.
And that trims Farmington's lead to 2. Notre Dame is only down 2 now, 7-5, with 2 minutes and 50 seconds left in the first. And that is a turnover. No, excuse me, it is a foul on Cape Notre Dame as Sophie Thurman, Jr. Sophie Thurman. Will be inbounding the ball for
45 Welter and number 10 Brennan in for Cape Notre Dame. Thurman looking for trouble here, can't find it. That is a 5-second violation. The fourth turnover here in the first quarter. As it's just silly mistakes at this point.
Very, very, very disappointing.
Notre Dame inbounds to Brennan. A little pump fake there, gives it to 25. Chapman gives it to 15, no good. Rebound by Notre Dame, back out to the top. Looking to reset the offense. Gives it to Brennan.
Back inside.
Down to Ziegler. Oh. Either a walk or a jump ball there.
Oh, jump ball. That is like our third or fourth jump ball this evening. And it will be Farmington's ball with 2:29 left in the first. Oh, to Thurman, and that is thrown over her head.
Too much mustard on that pass. This is a random note, but Jake, have you noticed that the Cape Notre Dame Bulldogs have a lot more people in blue out here and a cheerleading crew, and that's two things that Farmington doesn't have at home.
Where is our cheerleaders? Where are our cheerleaders? Where is the sixth man? I hear all of this talk about this cheering section that this school has, and I don't see it. We have a sign. No one's here. There's only 67 people here in attendance. Most of them are from blue, or they're from the other school. Where are they? Where is the sixth man? I want to know. You give me answers.
Sixth
right
man,
now.
MIA, missing in action.
Right now.
Ball inbound to West, almost loses it. Keeps it, gives it to Roethlisberger.
Back to Thurman, to West. And the Roethlisberger back to Thurman.
West looks to set something up. In tight pressure there, and that is a timeout called by Sansergall.
We have a timeout here called by Coach Rusty Sansergall. That is Farmington's first. And with 1:43 left in the first, the Knights are up 7-5, and we are going to go to our commercial break with our quick sponsors. We'll be right back. Thank you.
Sometimes all it takes to be a dad is remembering how to be a kid again. Take time to be a dad today.
In the first.
All right, we are back here. Farmington setting up their offense. Emma West down low, little bump, no foul. A tip pass there by number 25 of Cape Notre Dame, Chapman. It'll maintain possession with Farmington. Thurman gives it to Tucker. Tucker under a double team gives it to the open West. On top, she dribbles past the defender, looking down, can't find anything. And a travel there, another turnover.
Another turnover by the Knights.
Sloppy game so far.
Sloppy top. Migos.
Number 10, Samantha Brennan.
Oh, that
and
oh,
there's
travel.
Another travel.
Holy cow,
back-to-back turnovers.
Back-to-back. Got to come like back-to-back.
Thurman inbounds to Tucker. Tucker to Brackett. Brackett inside.
Brackett inside. No. Oh, no good. What a dominant presence Riley Brackett is inside. Wow, it's just so exciting to watch her play.
Hmm. We have a foul on Farmington.
And we have some substitutions here for both Notre Dame and Farmington. Oh, Riley Brackett is getting a breather here with 106 in the first, and we are shooting. Is this 1-1, I believe, or are they shooting 2? Oh, we got more subs here. We got more subs. Oh,
got to check in.
Oh, got to check in. Come on. Basics. Basic thugonomics.
First shot from Notre Dame, number 45.
Oh, it is a 1-1, and it is no good.
We are now at the 1 minute mark
of the first
quarter. West gives it to Tucker in the corner. Tucker gives a little shake and bake over another risky cross court pass to Thurman. Gives it to. I cannot see because of the scoreboard there. Under the buckets cut off.
We apologize for the seating that we have been given in this this contest tonight.
Number 23 of Notre Dame, Samantha Feeney, is checking in for 45. Lexi
Feeney.
Welter.
Feeney.
Davis wide open, shot up, and it is good.
Swish.
Still in single digits, though.
9-5.
Into the first quarter. 40 seconds to go. Is it to 21, Cheyenne Sander. Deep down inside, wide open into the corner.
Looks like she wanted to take that three.
And I think that was supposed to be a pass.
Nobody home.
Yeah.
Miscommunication. A lot of miscommunication so far in this game, ladies and gentlemen.
28.6 to go. 9-5, Nidets lead. They give it to Davis, who almost travels, doesn't travel, picks the ball up.
Back to Thurman.
Thurman to West on the Knights reading, looking for someone. Gives a little crossover there to Roethlisberger up top. She gives it to Davis. 13 seconds to go. She gives it to West outside for a three ball. That is money in the bank.
Money in the bank.
5 seconds to go as Notre Dame brings
money
it up.
Team.
A shot from way back there.
Whoa, air ball.
Nothing but air there.
And after one, the Knightettes are up 12-5, and we will be right back after this commercial break. Thank you.
Bigger is better with A&W's 1/3-pound double cheeseburgers. Giant double stacks of 100% U.S. beef steak burgers loaded with your favorite toppings. Demand bigger. Only at your local A&W.
Here to say, come on, Sarah.
Hey, come on, Sarah. I'm pretty sure we got more.
For a limited time, A&W's 100% Wisconsin white cheddar cheese curds are available in a large, plenty-to-go-around portion, the perfect side or snack to divvy up with a friend. Prepare to share. Only at your local A&W.
With everything always improving, why is our banking falling behind? With monthly service fees and ATMs that take your money right back. Introducing Kasasa, free hardworking accounts. You'll earn when you bank and earn when you swipe and get those ATM fees back in your pocket. Free checking with rewards. Carried locally at Belgrade State Bank. Do you, Kasasa?
All right, and we are back starting the second half. And Jake, as we were talking about in the first quarter, a lot of sloppy play, and we barely got over double digits on one side, 12-5. And what have you seen from the first quarter so far?
A lot of turnovers, a lot of sloppiness, a lot of things that need to be worked on in practice.
A lot of fundamentally.
And here we are. We got a three ball for Notre Dame, trimming their deficit to three.
It ain't drizzling twos. It is raining threes.
Raining threes. Good old Chris Rock for you, grown-ups. Great film. Go check it out.
Tucker gives it to Davis. Davis at the elbow, drives in off the glass, off the rim.
Oh, look at here. We have We have some people coming into the crowd now. We're starting to fill in some people here. Good to see some fellow Knights students out here and alumni to support our girls basketball team.
It's always a thrill. Tucker passes half court, gives it to Thurman.
Thrills in the night.
Over to West. Tucker looking to set something up. Thurman wide open outside to Davis, who's open.
Davis
popping it from three.
Oh, and it is no good.
It is not raining threes or drizzling twos. That is nothing.
Zero. You've been denied. You've gone bankrupt.
Shot is up from the corner.
And
it's
is
a three.
Good.
I can't see who made it because
Allison
of our
Tucker.
Seating.
I believe that is number 12 sophomore Allison Tucker, the only sophomore playing varsity for the Farmington Knights. Very junior, and a lot of juniors on this team. A lot of juniors. Full of juniors.
A shot up by 25. That is good. Number 25, Haley Chapman.
Everybody's starting to warm up
home.
Here. It's looking like the three. It's looking like the three-point contest out here.
Like NBA Jam.
NBA Jam.
We're heating up.
NBA Jam. Great game. Go purchase it. Please go purchase it.
Davis, a long two rimmed out, no good. Rebound by number 22, Ziegler.
As well, if you are currently live streaming this on FHS Night Vision Media on YouTube, go check out all the previous stuff that we have ever published on there. It is quality over quantity. We have quality. We also have quantity as well. And go check out our latest short film. He's my strength. Good stuff. Thank you. The first free throw
by Samantha Brennan
is
good.
Good. Trimming their lead, their deficit, I mean, to five.
So we're finally broken both teams into the double digits here. This could be a four-point lead after that, and it is. Number 31 checks in for the previous shooter, Brennan. That is Brooke Blankenship.
Also, what I've noticed about Cape Notre Dame, they have a lot more depth. They have a lot more people.
Yes.
They're subbing people in and out.
Like a lot
and
more
as,
subs.
And as Farmington,
they only made about
nothing.
One round of subs, and that
nothing.
Was the last minute and a half of this first quarter. Paul sets up the offense, gives it to Thurman. Thurman from outside, looking, finds West up top, dishes under the corner to Davis. Davis to Roethlisberger, almost over her head. She somehow makes the play. DePaul's a long three. That's Steph Curry
no
range. No good.
That Davis was Jimmer just, range right there.
Davis
BYU
with
days.
A forearm to the head, and that is
a double dribble there.
Come
another
on,
another
turnover.
Civic Center stuff right there. Come on.
Another turnover. Timeout by Cape Notre Dame.
We have a timeout by Cape Notre Dame with 5:54 left in the second. The Knights are up 17-13, and we will be right back after this quick break. Thank you.
Zestier, cheesier, and always something new packed with fresh ingredients. And don't forget the wings for only 50 cents on Sundays and Mondays. CC's Pizza in Farmington. We'll CC you there.
All right, a quick commercial break here. We are back as... All right, we are back to action here in the Farmington Gym. Soon to be old Farmington Gym as the $9 million construction is underway.
$9 million. You know how much money that is? That's a lot of freaking
money. A lot of Pauls crosses up. A defender drives in, loses the ball. That is another turnover.
Another turnover.
It is just getting bad out here.
But what I will say, the offense on both sides, both teams, has picked up significantly.
Oh, yes.
And I
was
very happy about
quarter.
It. And another bucket, trimming Notre Dame's deficit, 17-15. Will Farmington get a stop? We'll see here with 5:28 left to go in the second.
Davis gives it to
Thurman.
They
answer. Not question, like the Allen Iverson shoes, they will give an answer.
Paul's
and the three is, oh,
sink.
Money.
Paul's from three. 5-point lead for Farmington. Now the defense has to clamp down here. Clamp season. Shout out to Janoris Jenkins. There it is, a steal.
Don't even get me started about the Rams.
Crosses him up. Davis off the
no good.
Here. Offensive foul.
Offensive
a
foul.
Charge, maybe. That is on Davis. That is a charge. And I believe that is Davis's second of the game.
in for the end of the game for the Knights is Bradley Brackett and juniors Bradley Brackett, both juniors, and Haley Graving. Taking a seat is Rachel Roethlisberger and
Sophie Thurman.
Splash Brothers. We have two maybe young Splash. Oh, what a pass!
Pauls gives it to Brackett down low. She gives a power dribble up. No good. Rebound by Davis, tips it to Bracken. That is good. Constant offense here, something we didn't see in the first quarter.
Offense is definitely picking up this quarter. A lot more exciting basketball. Very close game.
Here we go. Kim Notre Dame on the offensive end. Looks for a three, doesn't take it.
Good move there.
Shakes off that defender as Kim Notre Dame resets their offense. Almost the backcourt there. Got to have court awareness. That ball is tipped. No foul. Farmington possession. Another turnover.
A lot of turnovers. Can't have it. We won't have it. I promise you. It's a promise. All Night Vision Media viewers.
Brackett down low. No glass. No rim needed. That's straight money. As Brackett puts up another two, and Farmington's lead is growing.
Farmington's up by six with 3:48.
Could be three here.
In the first half, and that is an air ball like DeAndre Jordan's free throws the other night. Did you see that?
Yeah.
Airballed two free throws in a row. That was something right there.
That's why I usually hack DeAndre Jordan late in the game and get him to the line. He's very low. I believe it's like 44% from the free throw line.
That is what humans would say, trash. No disrespect, DeAndre Jordan. Terrific defensive player. But
he can do things down low.
We are here to talk about the Farmington Knights, not DeAndre Jordan. I apologize.
Pauls dishes in off the glass, no good, and a foul on Pauls as she went over the back. 3:24 to go in the half. 24-18. As number 22 of Cape Notre Dame, Allie Ziegler. Ziegler, you tell me, I don't know. She's at the line for two.
We apologize for any mispronunciations of names. Thank you.
And the ref has to rebounce the ball here, give it back to Ziegler. Puts the shot up first, and no good. Bradley Brackett thought it was a 1-1. That's incorrect. She'll take another. Thank you, sir. May I have another free throw? Yes, you may. Second one is up. And it is good. 24-19, Farmington over Cape Notre Dame.
After that free throw, that trims their deficit to five.
A lob pass, very risky pass.
Turnover
once again.
Thurman.
Brennan gets a steal. She puts up a floater. That is off the glass and good. Finally, we see some backboard, Jake.
Backboard. I love backboard. Love it.
It's the fundamental.
Fundamentals.
Running a press here as Cape Notre Dame. Farmington breaks it. They go inside. Lexi Paul's double teamed through two defenders.
Oh,
no good.
It is no good.
This part of this quarter has been very fast-paced. We've seen back-to-back.
By Cape Notre Dame is no good. Rebound by Bradley Brackett.
Oh, she's got numbers here. 4-on-1. Takes it herself.
Oh,
still
wow.
Still gets to go. Bradley Brackett doesn't
what
want assists.
She wants buckets. She wants it all.
She doesn't want assists.
By far the most exciting player out here for the Farmington Knights.
And
that
she does want
a
foul, though.
Football tackle. Excuse me, I don't believe this is the LFL, but that would be that she is shooting 1-1.
And that is Brackett's third foul today. Not even at the end of the half.
Fouls can't be no bad fouls, no cheap fouls.
Got Ziegler. Got,
now she has to
the
take
first.
A seat.
Roethlisberger in for Brackett. Another miss by Ziegler. Paul's running in transition. She stops. Let's the offense set. A three by Paul's. Nothing.
Oh,
off
no
the
good.
Rim.
Good look, though. Great look. Great attempt. Sometimes you just come up short. And with 2:21 left in the first half, your Farmington Knights are currently winning 26-22 over Cape Notre Dame.
And Notre Dame with a rebound.
By Cape Notre Dame.
As number 31, Brooke Blankenship runs the offense. She finds number 23, Samantha Feeney. Back to Sander. inside. Looks for the pass, doesn't get it. Flipping it around now. Baseline run. She gets it. She puts it up. Fouled by Roethlisberger. That'll send her to the line with 1:52 to go. Trying to trim that lead from 4-2. Roethlisberger's first. Blankenship's shot is up. No good.
No good. We have some subs here for the Cape Notre Dame Lady Bulldogs.
And that sub is number 12, Faith Esner, for number 25, Haley Chapman. Blankenship shot is up. No
and
good.
That is no good.
Rebound by Roethlisberger.
By Roethlisberger as she hands it off to Pauls as she runs the offense. She is the general of this team.
Pauls gives it to West. West pump fakes a pass, gives it up top to Graven. Raven to Roethlisberger on the wing. Oh. To Thurman up top. A lot of movement here by this offense.
Roethlisberger inside and back out to Graven. The Knights seem to be holding on to the ball here, trying to chew some clock.
There are no rush to score here. And
no shot clock in high school, ladies and gentlemen. No,
there
no
is
shot
a
clock.
Travel.
We got a travel call. That will stop the clock with 1:16 left.
As number 10, Samantha Brennan comes in for Brooke Blankenship.
As Cape Notre Dame gains possession.
Notre Dame dribbles down. Tight coverage there by Graven. Dish to the wing. That
three
shot is up.
Is
no good.
No good.
Rebound by Sander.
By Cape Notre Dame. Oh, turnover by Notre Dame as Sophie Thurman for Farmington recovers. We are under a minute left now in the first half. Farmington is still
swatted.
Oh, well, we got an impressive block. No, no, no.
Inbounds play.
Oh, inbounds play is, and a turnover by the Knights. Recovered by, oh, Cape Notre Dame. Oh, we had a scramble for the ball
there.
All kinds of confusion, excuse me. I apologize. We have subs for Farmington as junior Catherine Banger comes into the game. To give Lexi Pauls a quick breather before half. Notre Dame for three, and it is good. Trimming their deficit to one with 35 seconds left in the first half. Wow, what an exciting game. A lot better quarter. A very good first half of basketball, minus all the turnovers and fouls. We have another foul. Speak of the devil, another foul.
First free throw is up by number 12.
And that ties the game.
Faith Esner is good.
Notre Dame's on a little run here.
As Farmington can go into the half with a low losing score. Ball is rebounded, dished out, back out.
Oh,
shot up from three.
Is
it is
good. They're on fire right now. What a run.
NBA Jam style. 13
Notre Dame
seconds
takes
left.
Their first lead of the game.
Ooh, ankles. Graven looks to set up the offense in a hurry. 6 seconds on the clock. West calling for someone to get open. Ball is out to Thurman. She chucks up a long three.
No good. And that is your first half of basketball, ladies and gentlemen. Notre Dame went on a run this quarter and took the lead 29-26. We will be back after this. After these messages. Thank you. Have a great evening.
This is your year. You're ready to become a homeowner, or maybe find your dream home. Have you been waiting to refinance? No matter the situation, First State Community Bank can provide the mortgage that's right for you. Rates are low, so see the team at First State Community Bank today to get started. Remember that when it comes to your finances, success starts here.
Divorce has many fears. Losing a child doesn't have to be one of them.
Hi, I'm Jim Willis. I've been practicing law in the Farmington area since 1986. Divorce is a very difficult time. You don't have to go through it alone. Please give me the opportunity to help you.
Mineral Area College, your next step. Enroll today at mineralarea.edu.
The Steak and Shake half-price happy hour is upon us. One must train to awaken at 2 a.m. for hand-dipped milkshakes.
But there's another one during the day, between 2 and 5 p.m.
Happy hour just got happier. Get half-price fall shakes now from 2 to 5 at Steak and Shake.
Now at Qdoba Mexican Grill, extras aren't extra. So you can pack your favorite entrees full of flavor. Try something new today at Qdoba Mexican Grill in Farmington.
America loves a fish fry. And in the Corktown part of Detroit, there's a place called Nancy Whiskey's that's famous for one. Nothing fancy, just a tasty good time. But you don't have to go to Nancy's for fish that tastes that special. Just come on over to Long John Silver's. Rediscover the taste you love. Long John Silver's, we're America's fish fry.
We're always looking for better ways to do things. But with some banks, better for them isn't always better for you.
You've reached MegaBank. Press 1 to hear your current balance. Press 2 to hear these options again.
Introducing free Kasasa checking. When you do stuff for us, like swipe your debit card or get e-statements, we make it even better for you with cash back and refunds on ATM fees. Kasasa. Carried locally at Belgrade State Bank. Do you Kasasa?
Zestier, cheesier, and always something new packed with fresh ingredients. All you can eat for only $5.55. CC's Pizza in Farmington. We'll CC you there.
I want to eat apples and bananas. I need to eat apples and bananas. Why can't I eat?
One in five children struggles with hunger in America. Support the Feeding America nationwide network of food banks to help provide meals to those in need. Join us at feedingamerica.org.
We taught him how to hit a baseball. How to hit a receiver. The strike zone. The net. You taught him how to hit the upper corner. You even taught him how to hit the open man. But how much time have you spent teaching him what not to hit?
Hey, did you know 2.4 million loving cats and dogs in shelters and rescues need our help to find a home? Let's go to the shelterpetproject.org and meet a few who are in a shelter near you. Harlow. Oh, she's one great listener who loves to hear all your stories. My kind of cat. Cerulo is a sweet, goofy boy who's eager to please. Sounds just like another dog I know. So go to the shelterpetproject.org, search your local shelters and rescues, and go for a cuddle with your next best friend. Adopt.
Na 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 na, I love you so. I love you, I love you. La 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 la, la 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 la.
We're here.
Yay!
It's a short drive from your neighborhood to your naturehood. To find a neighborhood park or green space near you, visit discovertheforest.org.
How can I help my daughter with her reading?
Searching for help with dachshund reading.
No.
Let me try. Sarah's bright, but when she's reading, she has trouble sounding out words.
Playing world music.
What?
I give up.
Wait, I was trying to show you how Sarah feels every day. Frustrating, isn't it? Redirecting to understood.org.
Join parents and experts at understood.org, a free online resource about learning and attention issues to help your child thrive.
Hello and welcome to the second half action. 3 minutes left to go in this halftime break. We're coming back to give you a little recap and tell you what we thought, what we saw, and what we didn't like about that first half. Jake, as we said earlier, a lot of sloppy play and a lot of turnovers, and you hope we can get that corrected by the second half.
Yes, a lot of sloppiness, a lot of turnovers, a lot of fouls in the first quarter. I could see the rustiness in both teams getting back into the groove of things. And in the second quarter, they started to settle down, and there was a lot more. It was a lot more fun to watch. Offense was a lot more fast paced. A lot more fast paced. A lot of fast breaks. A lot of some threes. Some exciting things to watch. Going forward, I'm excited for the second half. It is a close game. I can't wait to see who wins.
And as you said, it's a very close game. Only a 3-point lead for Farmington, as Cape Notre Dame has made its way out of their tunnel. Farmington still getting a little halftime pep speech from the man, Rusty Sansergirl.
Man of the year. Man of the year. Every time he walks in the building.
Still have a minute 30. And Jake, Bradley Brackett getting in a little bit of foul trouble in that first half. 3 fouls already before halftime. If she does get into foul trouble, do you think that the Farmington Knightettes are going to try to move to a little more outside shooting game or stick with that inside post that they usually go with just with different people?
I think that they should start keep on feeding in on the inside, and then they will double up. They will double team inside, and that gives people, the outside shooters like Pauls and Davis for them and Tucker, for them to get open on the outside. So do that. It'll keep them on their feet, keep them on their toes. They won't know what's coming, and that should secure a win in this tournament and advance their placement.
Bow! All right, Farmington has made its way back onto the court. As we are under a minute until we restart our action, 3 points ahead is Farmington. The last words given by both coaches to both teams. Get their mind right, get that psyche ready to go, because we're about to break this bad boy open with some action. Graven taking the inbound at half court as
it is Farmington's ball to begin the second half. We've already played one half of basketball. Excuse my French.
Graven gets the inbound and will give it to Pauls. Never mind, she will not give it to Pauls. She will give it to Notre Dame defender.
And somewhere in the crowd,
getting hit in the head.
A lovely lady there just got hit in the head, and we apologize for that. Hope she's quite all right.
Pauls setting the offense, gives it to Tucker on the wing. Pump fake, dishes down to Brackett, like we said, post game, and a turnover. That's something we haven't seen, right, Jake? Turnover.
Turnover, yeah. I mean, we've seen a lot of those. I was hoping that they would go out and do something about it this half, and not off to a great start, but still.
That is Briley Brackett's
third turnover.
Lots of them in this game. Turnovers for everyone. It's like an Oprah show. You get a turnover.
Yeah, everyone gets a turnover. I feel like everyone has had a turnover in this game.
That is
a lot of turnovers.
Time. Graven gets the ball down, gives it to Brackett as she can't handle it, and looks like we're going to have a defensive foul. Number 22 on Cape Notre Dame. That is Allie Ziegler, her first. It's another inbounds play from Graven to...
Oh, well, could be a five-second violation. No, and she gets Tucker. It off just in time as...
There's a double dribble. And one more to the list. Another turnover.
Another turnover for the Knights.
Looking, two turnovers already.
Looking ice cold right now. In 45 seconds, they have two turnovers already on both of their possessions.
Cape Notre Dame.
Drives inside to 22.
22. Ziegler gives it to 10. Brennan. And they will keep possession. A little bit of spin move there to Brennan. Dishes it down low to Ziegler.
Good defense here by the Knights.
Yes, great lockdown defense.
And that shot is up and no good. And another rebound by Cameron Dane. They have definitely won the rebound matchup so far in this game.
A lot of offense here. Shot is up from the corner. That is good. Number 15, Maddie Uran.
Cameron Dane's momentum just keeps shifting and shifting and back into this half. You know, they're playing great right now.
Wide open bracket.
Wide open for bracket, and it is good. What a game Brackett is having. Great game. Trims Farmington's deficit to 4. Oh,
and another turnover. What's new? Interesting, if you do look at the scoreboard, Farmington is not home on the scoreboard despite being at the home arena. They are actually away. They are the guests down by 4. I previously myself thought that they were in the lead looking at the scoreboard, but that is switched.
Yes, they are down by 4.
So just in case you guys catch a glimpse of the scoreboard on the great camera work by our Night Vision media crew, it is
Tanner Grimes, everybody.
Tanner Grimes and Braden Grief.
Greatest of all time. If it wasn't for them, I don't know where my life would be.
A miss by Pauls, rebound by Davis, and that is a jump ball. Possession goes to Farmington. As number 21, Cheyenne Sander is in for 22. Allie Ziegler.
It's 5:35 in the third quarter. Farmington is down still by 4 points. And we have a foul on the floor here, and it is Notre Dame's ball.
Notre Dame resets the offense.
Notre Dame looks to be slowing it down here. And another turnover for the Cape Notre Dame Bulldogs. Turnover happy here for both sides.
Davis inside. Very bad shot selection there. And double coverage, both people straight up. That was just a poor shot choice by Davis. As number 22, Ziegler is coming in for Sander.
Still Farmington's ball, inbounding the ball for the Knights.
Number 25,
Graven.
Haley Chapman is out for Notre Dame. Almost a steal by Notre Dame. Brackett keeps possession, gives it to
Davis.
Davis out
to Pauls.
Pauls resets the offense.
Pauls looks to reset the offense here. She dumps it off to Tucker. Back to Graven, and it is off her hands, and it is a turnover for the Knights.
Graven tried to take that ball and run with it before she even had possession. That was a problem. So quick to get that ball out of her hands and move the ball, she didn't
even
regain
possession.
She was
moving before the ball was even there.
And there's another turnover, something we've seen way too much. Pause all the way across court to Tucker.
Farmington with only 2 points scored this quarter.
Tucker into bracket. This will give you some points. No, it won't. Rebound by Ziegler.
Just a little short on that shot.
Brennan takes it down low. She puts it up, swatted by Brackett.
What defense Brackett is playing. Fantastic. Wonderful. Oh, good pass, good pass, good outlet pass there to Davis with the shot, and it is
not
no
enough.
Good. Still the skid here. the drought for Farmington. Thought it was a drought. It is a drought. Indeed, is it a drought. They've only scored 2 points this half. As for the Cape Notre Dame Bulldogs, they have scored 3. It has only been Farmington's playing good defense, not a whole lot of offense this quarter.
Yeah, this is the polar opposite of what the end of the first half was for both teams. A lot of fast pace breakaways in that first half ending, but now it is just slowed down. No points on either side. A lot of turnovers, a lot of sloppiness. It's not the great defense. It's just the lack of offensive talent, I think, from both sides.
Yes, and that is a shot. Oh, and a good shot. Can't lay it in the glass.
Dish outside, and another travel. Both teams need to go back and work on these fundamentals as Emma West subs in for Pauls. And a timeout by Cape Notre Dame.
And we are going to be on a commercial break here. We'll be back with you after our sponsors. Thank you.
Everything's better when it's handmade, especially A&W's hand-breaded chicken tenders. Delicious 100% white meat chicken, made right and served with your choice of sauces, including our signature spicy papa sauce. Try them now at your local A&W.
The one and only A&W Papa Burger. It's everything a burger should be. Big flavor, no nonsense. Stacked with classic toppings and our signature papa sauce. The Papa Burger, always at your local A&W.
All right, we are back live with this great night at basketball action. As Tucker takes the offense past half court, puts a move on, gives it to Graven. Graven on the baseline, pass tipped away, and it will stay Farmington ball.
With 3:12 in the third, your Farmington Knights are down by 4.
Only a total of 6 points scored in this
by
third
both teams.
Quarter.
6 points.
6 points combined as Roethlisberger looks to put a tally on the board for Farmington, and she does. Now it's only a 2-point deficit.
Farmington's only down 2 now with just under 3 minutes left to go, and that 3-ball is good. What a great shot. Advancing Cape Notre Dame's lead to 5. 35. Oh, and a steal for Cape Notre Dame, and the layup is good. Wow.
See, Farmington's got to take a timeout here to
calm
themselves down.
They got to talk things over here.
And there, it's got to happen. It's another turnover there. Fundamentally sound.
They got to slow things down here. They got to talk things over.
It went from a 2-point deficit to 7 just like that.
And a turnover for the Cape Notre Dame Bulldogs, and that can shift into Farmington's hand as they could get some points here on the board. And another turnover. Oh no, we got a foul here.
And that is on number 15.
My apologies.
Cape Notre Dame. Oh, number 10 actually. Samantha Brennan, her first. As Tucker takes the ball up court, gives it to Graven on the wing. Back to Tucker up top. Great defense there by Notre Dame. Almost cuts the pass off. Tucker goes down low. That ball is tipped off of Notre Dame. Oh, off of Farmington, maybe off a leg or an ankle there, and it is Cape Notre Dame ball.
With 2:09 left in the third, the Cape Notre Dame Bulldogs are up 37-30 over your Farmington Knights.
Cape Notre Dame sets up the offense, passes tipped down low, tipped again, and that is Farmington ball, a turnover.
Oh, we got a timeout called here by
Farmington, it looks like.
By Farmington, and your Farmington Knights are down 7 with 1:57 left in the third, and we will be back right after this commercial break.
Nothing compares to fresh, intense flavors of Qdoba Mexican Grill. So for your next event, don't forget to call us for Qdoba Catering. Add a kick to your next event with Qdoba Mexican Grill in Farmington.
All right, we'd like to keep things short and sweet here. We're already done with our commercial break. We are back to the action. Don't want to keep you waiting too long as Farmington takes the inbound to Davis. Davis over to Graven. Got to get past without hitting that 8 second. And they do. Almost a walk there, not called.
Yeah, there's a non-call right there. Letting that one go. There's a lot. Been a lot of turnovers so far in this game. Another turnover. Oh, no, they recovered it. Almost another turnover by Farmington.
Emma West takes over, gives it to Davis. And Davis takes ball across half court, gives it to Tucker to set the offense. Davis goes to the elbow. West passed down, and it is
another turnover.
It is getting ugly.
It's getting ugly here. The Farmington can't seem to score any points on offense.
Great crossover there by Brennan. Cape Notre Dame goes inside. That shot is blocked.
Whoa, nice block there by Farmington.
Davis looks to set up the fast break offense, almost loses it. Nowhere to go here. Gives it to Tucker.
Under 1 minute left in the third quarter. Knights are down seven, 37-30.
Back-to-back turnovers there as Cape Notre Dame.
And we have a foul. We will be shooting two here.
First shot is good.
And we have some subs here. Subbing in for the Knights is junior Sophie Thurman as Allison Tucker. It's a breather.
Shot is up. That is no good. Rebounded by Cape Notre Dame. They keep it in. They reset their offense with 20-something seconds to go. 24. A wide open shot just inside the three. No good. Rebound by West as she runs it up with 15 to go. West finds a wide open Graven on the edge. Gives it to Roethlisberger. She puts a power dribble down. She puts it up. That is good.
Oh, good shot. Roethlisberger's having a pretty nice game off the bench for the Knights, and providing a little bit of spark.
Five seconds to go.
Four points for herself in this quarter.
A long shot.
It is up.
Air ball.
Nothing.
No good.
Nada. And after three, Cape Notre Dame is up by six, 38-32. With one more quarter remaining, we will be right back after this commercial break.
Mineral Area College, your next step. Enroll today at mineralarea.edu.
Hi, welcome to CeCe.
Hey, they don't call it CeCe's for nothing.
Ride from your neighborhood to your naturehood. To find a neighborhood park or green space near you, visit discovertheforest.org.
And what do you know? A turnover.
Let's see if the Knights can get some points on the board, regain the lead, and come home with a victory. It would be nice for Farmington, the ladies' team, to get a victory on their first game of the year. Get some momentum in their hands for tomorrow in this tournament. Sophie Thurman was wanting the ball really bad. She was wide open.
There she is, still open. Wide open outside. Haley Graven, that is a two. That is also no good.
No good.
Rebound
and
by Brackett.
By Bradley
she
Brackett.
Puts it up.
And
no good as
no
well.
Good.
The offensive
another
woes
offensive
continue.
Rebound.
And a charge by Davis.
Oh, we got an offensive foul
That's
here.
That's her second charge, let alone foul of the game. Her third.
Just under 8 minutes here left in the fourth quarter. Her Knights are still down 6 points. Oh, three ball, and it is good. No, wait, that's a two. That's a two. My, excuse me, she foot was right on the line, and that extends Notre Dame's lead to eight. Oh, good pass inside, and we have a block here. And it is on the floor.
And that foul is on number 45, who's getting subbed out right now, Lexi Welter, her third. As that ball's on the floor to Davis. Wide open, Paul's in the corner, doesn't find her. Need to have better court vision there.
Oh,
Paul's just standing wide open in the corner.
Another turnover for the Knights.
That's where they have to make up for their mistakes. They have a wide open player in the corner shouting for the ball. And she doesn't see it. Davis goes into triple coverage. You just have to be frustrated.
Very frustrated if I'm Coach Russ Sansergaard right now. But they do get another. Pauls looks inside. Tries to slow down the offense. Bracket posts up. And we have a 3-second lane violation. And it will be Notre Dame's ball with 6:14 left to go, left in the game. Cape Notre Dame Bulldogs are up 40-32.
Cape Notre Dame sets up their offense. Tight defense there by Davis. Gives it to number 12, Faith Essner, who sets up the offense. Looking for something, finds nothing. There it is. And deep down to the corner, a long two shot is up, no good. Rebound by number 15 of Notre Dame, Maddie Uriah.
Rebound by Elena Davis as she dribble drives down into the lane, and we have a foul on the floor. 5:36 left to go. Notre Dame is still at 40-13. We have some subs here for Notre Dame as Haley Graven for Farmington is inbounding the ball. Junior Haley Graven. Excuse me, they switch it, and Sophie Thurman is now inbounding the ball for Farmington.
Lob pass taken by Brackett, who is hacked on the play by number 10, Samantha Brennan, looking to create a fast break opportunity there, but instead picks up her second foul of the game.
Another
Thurman
play.
Gives it to Pauls in the corner.
Pauls
she's
in
been
the corner
wanting
for
it all
three,
night.
And it is no good. Been ice cold from three all night.
Pauls. Tip pass, another turnover by Farmington. Notre Dame regains possession. Ball is tipped in low.
Side, and it is.
Is that
a foul?
That
is a foul.
Yes, it is, as number 22, Allie Ziegler, will shoot two for Cape Notre Dame.
This is Brackett's fourth foul in the evening. One more, and she is done. Toast. So she has to play smart here in the remaining minutes of this game in order to give the Knights a chance to win. And Pauls drives inside. Rebound by Elena Davis, and that attempt is no good. The third attempt is still no good as Notre Dame gets the rebound with under 5 minutes left. The Cape Notre Dame Bulldogs are up 41-32. The Knights have yet to score any points this quarter. Excuse me. Another shot made by Cape Notre Dame, extending their lead to 11 as the Knights' chances of winning this game are dwindling away. With just under 4:30 left in the game.
The Knights really need an offensive spark here, and Elena Davis could give them there with that basket.
Oh,
and
it's no good. And we got to wrestle for the ball here, jump ball.
That will stay with Notre Dame.
And it is Farmington's ball. Shot for Pauls outside is good.
Finally.
Some points here for the Knights. Pauls is good from three, trimming their deficit to eight as the Knights seem to be pressuring the ball. And we have another jump ball.
Which will benefit Farmington well.
No, it will not. It will actually benefit Notre Dame as they maintain possession. Notre Dame looking for some offense here. Cross-court pass as number 15 drives in. That ball is taken away by Brackett, a steal. Paul's looking to find some quick offense here.
There's under 4 minutes left. Farmington needs some quick scores spin. Here. And inside. Oh.
Paul's did a great job selling on that foul. Not a lot of contact there. She took the bump. As she will shoot two. A lot of subs in for
in
Notre
and out.
Dame.
Quick subs for Notre Dame here. I've noticed that throughout the night. Quick subs, quick breathers for people, quick subs. And it's working to their advantage at this point in the game. As Lexi's 1-1 is no good. As Notre Dame retains the ball, regains possession, should I say. With just under 3:30 left in the quarter. Notre Dame is up 43-35.
Notre Dame's offense, a lot of quick passes here, trying to keep the ball out of the hands of the Farmington Knightettes as they almost commit a turnover, but they have a wide open shot from the elbow. Shot
is
up and
good.
And now this deficit has reached
double digits.
Double digits, yes. A 10-point deficit for Farmington.
Oh, another turnover by the Knights. Caused a turnover.
Trying to keep the ball out.
Another
from
shot.
Down long to...
And it is... Oh, no, in and out. That looked good from here. Quick scores here. Shot for West is no good. And Notre Dame with the rebound. Another fast break opportunity, and she is fouled hard. Hacked going up for the ball. And she will be shooting two. Oh, we have a timeout here with Cape Notre Dame, up by 10 with 2:32 left in the game. We'll be right back after our sponsors. Thank you.
Everywhere that we go, he makes people laugh and makes people smile, and I feel like I have that quality.
He's the one who always takes me fishing.
I watch golf with him. And
I watch him cook, because when I grow up, I want to be a cook too.
We have the same faces like this.
Dad is the one, when you fall, that picks you up.
That unconditional sense of presence and reassurance is really what makes him my father.
Tim, we're back. Tim, we're back.
Tell me when we're back. My name is Borat.
All right, we are back once again to bring you this thrilling conclusion of Knightette basketball. 2:32 left. The Knightettes hoping that they can erase a 10-point deficit. Do not make that 11. It is a miss by number 23 of Cape Notre Dame, Samantha Feeney. Feeney!
Second free throw is
good. So
good.
11 points.
Extending Notre Dame's lead to 11 with 2 minutes and 30 seconds left to go in this game. Will the Knights make a scoring run here, or will Notre Dame just put a fork in them? Oh, we have a foul. Shooting 1-1 here, double bonus, I believe.
Davis at the line, 1-1, no good. Rebound by number 23, Feeney, which is outletted to Brennan as she is looking to slow down their tempo and not cause any dumb turnovers to get Farmington on a run. Wide open shot, defense covers quickly. Deep down in the post, Davis goes for a steal, gets a tip, and she does come up with a steal. Lana Davis drives the ball a lot past
the fourth.
Pauls drives in, puts a stutter step on. Davis wide open up top.
And again, that shot is an air ball tipped
again
as she went up for the
Davis,
shot.
Davis, just horrible shot quality. Even though it's not right in your face, two people right in front of you jumping up in the air to contest that shot when you have open players needs to work on that to have better court vision and find her open people. As Notre Dame sets
90 up seconds
offense.
Left in this contest as Notre Dame looks to run the clock out and take home a victory in this first round of the Farmington Invitational. We have a walk here called Farmington ball.
And a timeout here, most likely by Farmington.
Timeout by Farmington as they look to talk things over, maybe get some fast break here. And we're not going away. We're going to stay here right with you this time as your Farmington Knights are down 11 with only 67 seconds left in the game. Will they prevail? Or will they go down and defeated? We'll find out here shortly.
And Farmington, obviously, with this being at home, their home tournament, they would love to come out with a great run here out of this timeout and come up with a way to shed down this lead. If they do not win, at least make it look a little better on themselves, but they just have been flat these past couple of minutes on offense.
In the second half period, they've only scored 11 points in the second half. You're not going to win many basketball games when you're only scoring 11 points.
In two quarters. Ball is inbounded to Pauls. Pauls looking for someone. She's tripped
and
up.
And that is a turnover for Notre Dame. For
wide
Farmington as Notre Dame goes
there.
Up for the layup.
Got
and it.
It
is good.
I would say that this game is done.
This game looks to be over here for you. We have a foul. Oh, foul on Notre Dame there.
Tucker's
first
shot
is no good. We have been ice cold from the free throw line all day. And that is still Notre Dame's ball with just 41 seconds left in the game. Your Knights are down 13 points. It looks like that Notre Dame will be coming away with the victory to this evening in their first round of the tournament. We have a timeout by Cape Notre Dame.
Don't know what they need to discuss here. They pretty much have this game in the bag.
With 37 seconds left in the fourth. The Knights are down 13. This has been a rough second half for the Knights. Only scoring 11, like I said, 11 points this half. Not going to win many basketball games doing that.
And at the end of the second quarter, the Knights' offense looked like they were going to put together a run. They looked like they had a little bit of drive behind them, and it has just fallen flat.
They had the whole lead the first quarter and the whole second quarter. At the end of the second quarter, that three-pointer, they just went downhill after that, after the first half, getting down at the first half. It wasn't until late in the second quarter that Notre Dame took their first lead, and they've just had it ever since.
As Notre Dame looking to just run the clock out here, and Graven sends someone to the line, I believe. No, it is on the floor.
It is on the floor here. And we have some subs for Notre Dame with 23 seconds left.
As number 25, Haley Chapman takes a seat. The Knights looking for a turnover here, desperate, and Graven pushes the player
push
to their own bench for another foul as they are in the bonus, and now they will go to the line. Thank you.
That extends Notre Dame's lead. Just padding it up there, 49-35. And the second free throw is good. Notre Dame is up by 15 now, as they look to have won their first round, their win against their first opponent in the Farmington Invitational.
As Cape Notre Dame, as you said, Jake, will likely move on. And I am unaware if the Farmington Knights, as they put in another 2 points to just soften that deficit, I'm unaware if they will play again despite a win or a loss or not. I'm sure they get a consolation game, but that'll do it. Farmington loses, 50-37 on a very sloppy, turnover-filled game on both sides as Notre Dame comes out victorious. And, Jake, as we said, we hope to see a lot of Knights improvement along with the fundamentally, they're just not fundamentally sound, nothing going on for them there.
Yes, I hope to see a lot of improvement tomorrow. They started off a little slow, a little rusty, and at the second quarter they played great. They were moving the ball, they were scoring points, they had the lead, and until late in the second quarter when they got down by that three-pointer, they've been down ever since, and they only scored 13 points in this half, in the second half, and that's not going to win many basketball games for you.
No,
but
won't.
There's always tomorrow, and we will be back with you tomorrow for more coverage of the Farmington Invitational. Everyone, have a great American night. I'm Jake Jackson, and this is Cole Sutton.
Stay based, everyone.
Stay based. That's right. Bye. I'm leaving.